A very good morning to everyone. So today we are going to discuss about the topic of competitive learning and then self-organizing computational map, that is a Kohonen network. We are going to discuss it briefly. So first about the competitive learning. In the competitive learning, the neurons compete among themselves to get activated. When I am comparing with the Hebbian learning, several output neurons can be activated simultaneously. In competitive learning, only a single output neuron is activated at any time. Okay, so that's the difference they are saying about with the Hebbian learning. With the Hebbian learning, several output neurons can be activated simultaneously. At the same time, they can able to activate. But here, only in the competitive learning, only the single output neuron will be activated. So that's a major difference in both this learning, and then the output neuron that wins the competition is called the winner takes all neuron. So that's a concept over the competitive learning. Those who are winning, the output neuron which wins the competition will be getting reward. So the idea behind the competitive learning was introduced in the early 1970s. In the late 1980s, Teuho Kohonen introduced a special class of artificial neural networks that is called self-organizing feature maps. So these maps are based on a competitive learning. So then the question asked, what is a self-organizing feature map? So that is a Kohonen network. The functionality is that it's like our brain is dominated by the cerebral cortex, a very complex structure of billions of neurons and hundreds of billions of synapses. The cortex includes areas that are responsible for different human activities like motor, visual, auditory, somatosensory, etc., and associated with different sensory inputs. So here each sensory input is mapped to a corresponding area for a cerebral cortex. So that's the thing. So how they are mapping with the sensory input to the corresponding cerebral cortex is matters here. The cortex is a self-organizing computational map in the human brain. So here when we discuss about the human brain, the cerebral cortex plays a role here, where we have millions of billions of neurons are there, and then each one is connected with or mapped with the cerebral cortex to do the respective functionalities. So that's what the self-organizing structure is obtained for the Kohonen network. And then here the feature mapping of Kohonen model is shown here. So here how the input has been passed to the Kohonen layer is, if I give the network as with ones and zeros through the input layer to the Kohonen network, which is shown here, and then if we pass zeros and ones, that is in the B part figure that I have shown, and then A part figure, ones and zeros, if we pass, how the network will be reacting, the structure is represented here, and then how the Kohonen network will be providing a topological mapping this model has a capability to provide the topological mapping by placing the fixed number of input patterns from the input layer into a higher dimensional output or a Kohonen layer. That is what we have seen in the previous model, that the fixed number of inputs is been fed to the Kohonen layer, that is either zeros or ones, or next as ones or zeros. So this is done in the part of Kohonen model. By fixing the number of input patterns, we can able to obtain the topological mapping. A training in the Kohonen network begins with a winner's neighborhood of a fairly large size. That's what we said, that here it follows the competitive learning. So we'll be getting the output as a winner neuron, which makes it competitive. Who is the winner? That will be taking the entire network. So thus the training proceeds with the neighborhood size gradually decreases. And then the architecture of the Kohonen network. So this is about the overall architecture of the Kohonen network. So here totally two layers are there in this architecture, input layer and the output layer. From the input layer, we are passing the inputs as x1 and x2, the possible inputs to the input layer. So from that, it will be passed to the coherent network, and then finally, which neuron is getting succeeded, we will be getting the output signal. Output signal, based upon that we can judge that the output which you have got is the desired output or not. The lateral connections are used to create the competitions between the neurons. So this is that they are saying that the lateral connections, this is the lateral connections which shows that a competition between the neurons. The neurons with the largest activation level among the neurons in the output layer becomes a winner. So here in the output layer we have got as y1, y2 and then y3. So these are the output signals which you have obtained. So in that, which neurons have the largest activation level, then that particular neuron only will be produces the higher output signal. So the activity of other neurons is suppressed in the competition. That means they have been getting failed. So the lateral feedback connections provides the excitatory or inhibitory effects depending on the distance from the winning neuron. So this is achieved by use of a Mexican hat functions. So the working principle of that Mexican hat function is that it describes how far the synaptic weights between the neurons have been applied in the coherent layer. So here it shows about the Mexican hat function of a lateral connection. So how the weight have been produced. If the weight have been at the negative level, it is of inhibitory effect, which is less than zero. And then if the weight is of greater than zero, this is of excitatory effect. So the connection strength is also established in this diagram. In the overall coherent network, the neuron learns by shifting its weight from inactive connections to the active ones. Only we know that the winning neuron will be allowed to learn or allowed for the training. So if a neuron does not respond to the given input pattern, then we need to shift the input patterns from inactive connection to active connection. We need to shift the input and then we need to check whether we are getting any signal from the network or not. So here by this way the network will be responding. The competitive learning rule defines a change, that is del of W of ij is applied to a synaptic weight W of ij. So based upon this rule only the network will be working on. So delta of Wij equal to alpha of xi minus of W of ij. That is a neuron j wins the competition n. If a particular neuron is loses the competition, then its resultant value will be zero. So where xi is the input and then the alpha is a learning rate parameter. So this is the function Euclidean distance, they have been calculated by using the formula of d equal to x minus of w of j modulus of x minus of w of j. So this can be written as summation of I equal to 1 to n x of I minus of w of ij the whole square. So this is the square root of. So by this way we can able to calculate the distance between a pair of n neurons. So with this way we can able to calculate the distance. And then to identify the winning neuron, the best matches with the input vector x should be applied based upon the condition j of x equal to minimum of j x minus of wj. So with this we will be identifying the winning neuron in the coherent network. Suppose we have a two dimensional input vector x presented to the three neuron coherent network. So the x value we have given and then the weights have been given. So with that we need to identify the best among the neuron. So we need to calculate the Euclidean distance based upon the formula we know that. So when we calculate the distance, so here in that the neuron 3 is a winning and its weight vector w3 is updated. So they are finding with a neuron 3 is the winner won, and then its weight vector W3 is updated according to the competitive rule. So for the competitive rule, again the formula is there. So if you apply in that, then the updated value will be taken account into the Kukina network. So here the updated weight vector W3 at the iteration P plus 11 is determined. So determine, so based upon this formula, W of 3 P plus 1 equal to W of 3 of P plus delta W3 of P. When we calculate this, we will be getting the weight vector of W3. So that is a winning neuron, which is closest to the input vector X. So in the competitive linear algorithm, so we have some few steps to be followed. The first step is of initialization. We need to initialize the synaptic weights to some random input value, some random values. Say the interval is from 0 to 1, 0, 1, and assign the small positive values to the learning rate parameter alpha. In the step 2, the activation and the similarity matching. So activate the Kuhnner network by applying the input vector X, and find the winner takes all the neurons J of X at iteration P. So we need to find the activation function by providing the input vector X. From that only we will be deciding the winning neuron by applying this formula J of X P equal to minimum of J X minus of W of J of P. So from that calculated formula, we will be identifying the resultant winner neuron. So the third step is of learning, update the synaptic weights by using the formula of W of IJ P plus 1, W of IJ P plus delta of W of IJ of P. So where W of IJ, the notation given as weight correction at the iteration P. By this way, the weight correction is done in the competitive learning. Again, the final deciding winner is based upon the competitive learning rule. Delta of W of IJ P equal to alpha of Xi minus of W of IJ of P, where J is the element of del of J P. If it is of 0, it will be as J is not the element of del of J of P. So where alpha is the learning parameter, and then del of J of P is a neighborhood function. And then this iteration should be fourth step is of iteration. We need to increase the iteration P by one step. That is, we need to go back to step 2, and then we need to continue the minimum distance Euclidean criterion is satisfied or not. If it is not satisfied, then we won't or any noticeable changes are occur in the feature map, we need to check it. So that we need to go back to step 2 to obtain the Euclidean distance to calculate it. And then in the competitive learning, the Kuhnner network, we know that a Kuhnner network with 100 neurons are arranged into form of a two-dimensional lattice with 10 rows and 10 columns. We are forming a Kuhnner network. The network is required to classify the two-dimensional input vectors. So the work of each neuron in the network should respond only to the input vectors occurring in that region. So a network is trained with 1000 two-dimensional input vectors generated randomly in a square region between the intervals of minus 1 and plus 1, and then the learning parameter alpha is equal to 0.1. So and then after generating the Kuhnner networks with hundreds of neurons, the initial random weight which you are providing will be the W of 1, j will be like that, and then W of 2, j is your Y parameter, W of 1, j is your X parameter. If you provide the a random weight to the Kuhnner network, the diagram is shown here, and then the network after the 100 iteration, the diagrammatic picture is shown here, and then the network after the 1000 iteration, the diagrammatic picture is shown here. So and then the network after the 10,000 iterations, here the Kuhnner network representation is shown here. So this is about the overall description about the competitive learning and then the Kuhnner network. Thank you.